league. I'm fine with me. I am God and God is me. Dream so big, might die in my sleep, but I ain't running from it. It's only a loss if you ain't learned nothing from it. I turned to a boss, remember I was under budget. Now I pay the staff off and fly them to another country. It's for the love of the game, never for the love of money. I used to wanna be like Wayne. I used to wanna be like Nip with the Cuban link chain. I used to rap like Jay, trying to make me a name. Now all I do is C5, and I'ma stay in my lane. I could do anything I put my mind to, that's facts. I wanna be a dealer, so I start. I like, so I went on and start flipping packs. I heard the drought 3 and said, dog, I'm a rap. I did that, superseded expectation. I refuse to settle for anything less than great.
It's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. Tonight we've got a great Sunday night matchup on tap as it'll be the Chicago Bears taking on the Philadelphia Eagles. The Bears send the kicking team out there, and they will send this one away. And no run back here, so they'll bring it out to the 25. Start on the ground with Swift. And he'll hope that this is not a sign of what's in store as he has to fight just to get back to the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the game's first play. And it's second down now. This defense for the Bears, they were excellent a week ago in the victory over Arizona.
And as in any game, takeaways are always a big key. They're always discussed on defense. There's an emphasis there. And they came away with 3 interceptions in that game.
Well, they had the run for no gain. Now they'll try again from the 25 on 2nd and 10. Pressure, and he's taken down. A Bears sack. Though certainly not the start they were looking for here as they come up on a 3rd and 14. Now Hurts changing up the play.
Hey, Silver, ready?
Now on 3rd and long, they'll look to throw. He'll air this one out for Boyd. Oh, his first throw of the game, going to be intercepted. Kyler Gordon picks it off.
Well, they certainly took a shot to open this game. I know it backfired with the interception, but no lack of bravado from that sideline at all. And look, they told us before the ball game, they wanted to be a little more dangerous on offense. They wanted to take a few more chances. That opening pass certainly set a tone. Maybe a turnover, but I don't think it'll stop them from trying again the rest of this game.
And some space here. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped. 25 yards, the pickup there, and also a first down. Thought they were going to have him down a lot earlier, but he was able to shed that tackle.
Shows the value of the weight room, doesn't it? Shows the value of the attitude when you run the football. Don't go down easily. Break a few tackles, gain some additional yardage.
And he swallowed up right near the line of scrimmage. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. You look at this Eagle defense. They've been pretty solid against the pass toward the middle of the pack, number 14 in the NFL.
And since this is such a good unit of covering passes downfield, I think that last play is typical of what we might see. A lot of short passes, see if they can generate some run after the catch. But nothing doing on that one.
And he slides and covers up at the end as he's going to be able to pick up decent yardage.
Here's a possibility again here, something he's done throughout this season. And maybe he puts him over 500 yards on the ground for the year. He's got to be thinking to himself, if I'm already at 500, what's to stop me from going for 1,000?
And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. Give him the 3rd down conversion, 5 yards on the play. They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields rolling to his right. Over the middle, and that's caught by Kmet. And brought down, but not before they get it inside the 10 to the 7. 18 yards there, and it'll be a 1st and goal.
Here we go.
More the motion man right. Fields tapping it forward. Jet sweep. Shrugs him off. And inside the five here before he's out of bounds right at the three.
A four-yard gain brings up second and goal at the Eagles' three-yard line.
So the ball position now at the three. Here's second and goal. Now Fields. That's complete to his running back, Herbert. And they call it a loss of a yard there. And that brings up a third down and goal.
That's planning. The defense actually has a plan. They blanketed everyone on that play. They were able to close it down and spill him for a loss.
Line of scrimmage at the four. Here's third and goal. Fields now to throw. Escaping the pressure right. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Justin Fields taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Bears take the early turnover and convert it into an opening touchdown. Now the try here for the extra point. And he's got it to make it 7-0 in favor of the Bears. Well, after the touchdown, here's the punter Trenton Gill to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And the interception on that opening drive winds up leading to the touchdown, so now it's kind of time to start over.
Yeah, it certainly is, and his first throw of the game. But I like the way his guys rallied around him. Oftentimes, the quarterback is the leader, right? He tells everyone what to do. In this case, I notice his linemen around him kind of patting him, saying, "Let's go, big boy. You're still our leader."
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. He gets this one to Boyd. And a 6-yard gain gets him right around the 43. Line of scrimmage, the 43 on second and four. They run out of the gun with Swift. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. 4 yards the pickup, first down. The Eagles had 6-7, a game under 500 on the year. Yeah, they've lost three straight here, and it kind of goes without saying, I guess, but they could certainly use a win.
Yeah, no doubt about that. There's a difference between a losing stretch and a losing streak, and right now, they're not playing their best football, but if they were to fall here, and now you're looking at going 4 games without a win, things could start compounding themselves pretty quickly from this point forward. Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. And it's incomplete.
But there is a certainty in this game. We know that wherever he goes, he's going to draw a big-time crowd.
Throws into double coverage there, and look, that's something that he's going to have to deal with a lot in this game, I'm sure.
Yeah, they were lucky to get away with that one where it just fell incomplete, but they're going to count on him to uncover late in routes and make some difficult catches.
He finds his man complete. That's Young. And this won't do it. He needed 6. He only got halfway there. They'll try and throw for it with Hurts. And he'll be touched down here, but not before he does pick up the first. They're able to keep the drive alive, 7 yards that time, and the decision to go for it proves to be a good one. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Now second quarter action from Philadelphia, and it's the Eagles in possession as they've got it with a 1st and 10. Hurts. He'll find Swift out of the backfield. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8 yard gain, second and two.
And they'll use him out of the backfield, and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. Four catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
They'll run right here with Swift. And he'll get him inside the 15 down to the 14-yard line. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Well, we always talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just about anything. But a lot of times, the play caller, he just looks down at his sheet, sees the short yardage runs, and goes to one of those.
On first and 10, it's Hurts. Flush to his right. And a big loss here as he's taken down. Now this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. Play action. Here's Hurts. He completes it to Boyd. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line.
Brings up third down.
Here now, a third and 20. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this second quarter. So Hurts is off, and on comes Jake Elliott for the Eagle field goal. The kick by Elliott is good, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field.
And nothing but green grass here, middle of the field. Touchdown, Chicago. Call that an 84-yard kick return. And the Bears are able to strike. I know a lot of special teams coaches, they just want to keep it away from him because that's what he can do.
And others have egos that their players can't keep up with. And they say, challenge him. Kick it to him. The way he runs, as fast as he is, I wouldn't challenge him at all. I'd do everything possible to keep it away.
He is just a blur when he gets a full head of steam, and he got a full head of steam there. He will return this from deep in the end zone. And he's probably realizing he should have stayed in the end zone as he can only muster a return to the 14-yard line. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a first and 10. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And they'll be stopped at the 28 on a play that started at the 14. They pick up 14. On first and 10, it's Gainwell. A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
No doubt about it. A really nice job there by the defense, not allowing him to get to the perimeter. But that means your defensive ends, your outside linebackers, the guys that you pay big money to sack the quarterback, they also have to have interest in the running game as well. And they did a nice job there of holding the point of attack and not giving ground.
Now Hurts going to get this to his running back, Swift. And they can't bring him down. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Throwing is Hurts. Airing one out for Boyd. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete.
Boy, that ball's just hanging up there, waiting to be intercepted. That looked doomed from the start, but they took the deep shot anyway, and fortunately, it winds up incomplete.
On second down, Swift. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. The Eagles on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This is third and 11. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete. So a couple of first downs on this drive, but it's looking like another empty possession.
And those empty possessions are certainly starting to pile up. So the adjustments that teams talk about all the time have to be taking place. They've got to analyze what's breaking down and figure a way to fix it.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth. And that will force a turnover on downs. On first and 10, it's Herbert. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. They don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Second down, they go back to Herbert. 4 yards on the pickup there as they get it back to a more manageable third and 7.
Kudos to the offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
First down marker at the 31. It's third down. From the gun, here's Fields. That is caught. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The 21 yards there as they convert on third. Now it's Fields. Flushed out right. He'll get that complete to his tight end, Kmet. And he'll take it from the 18 to the 15. A gain of 3.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route. And he ran it a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line. But once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
And he is in. Touchdown, Chicago. Khalil Herbert, his 11th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Bears will extend their lead in the final minute of the half. Extra point right down the middle. And the lead is up to 18 now. After the touchdown, here's the punter, Trenton Gill, to kick it away. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And the decision to bring it out, not a good one, as he's tackled at the 15. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk, this is a big decision here.
And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in. Second down. Here's Hurts. And that went too far in front. He couldn't reel it in. It's incomplete.
Well, this defense is certainly organized and playing off of each other because the rush is providing pressure and the coverage is forcing incompletions and capitalizing on mistakes. When you get every level on defense hitting at once, you get first half scores just like this one.
Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third. The Eagles send out their punter now as he's on to punt for the first time tonight. And here's a very low line drive, almost whiffed on it. It'll be just an 18-yard punt, and control of the football switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. The Bears offense ready to go for their next drive. And with great starting field position up near the 50, they might be one completion away from stealing a late field goal here. And he'll get this complete downfield to commit. Touchdown, Chicago! Cole Kmet in the final seconds of the first half. And the Bears are able to add on to their first half lead.
And that's a lead that excites a team as they head into the half. Good way to finish things off.
Yeah, able to extend that lead, and you always say it, that can totally change the complexion of half number two.
Yeah, it changes your morale, changes your outlook. But even before that, let's see if they decide to kind of squib kick or what they're going to do on the kickoff, because you don't want to give up a big play right before the half ends.
Good point. Well, from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. They'll throw now on the final play. Dancing to his left. And now he'll let this one go deep, back over the middle. That is incomplete. First half in the books. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth ready for quarter number three. Set to resume. Here we go with the second half. The Bears holding the lead and ready to receive the kick. And the fair catch signaled for and taken. So they'll begin this third quarter from their 25-yard line. At the line, prepping for their next drive, the Bears offense. And the first half definitely went their way, and this would seem to be a great opportunity to kind of put this game a little closer out of reach with a score here.
Yeah, and it's a...
There he goes, right side. And he takes this one in for a Bears touchdown. Justin Fields, 75 yards. And the Bears extend their lead yet again. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead grows even larger here in the third quarter. After the touchdown, here's the punter Trenton Gill to kick it away. And this will be returned from deep in the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23. Already at the line, this Philly offense set to go. The CD, they certainly know the hole that they face as they begin the second half. They have to do what precious few teams have done in NFL history, and that's try to come back from a four-possession deficit.
And, partner, you know, as that team gathers, they're saying to each other, you never say never, right? Because if you're on an NFL roster, that's how you have to think. You can always come back and win a ball game. And let's face it. face it, we saw a certain Super Bowl, a 25-point lead late that wasn't enough to put someone away. But that being said, this task is near impossible. Let's face it. And bottom line is, it officially becomes impossible if this possession is an empty one.
Hurts sets up to throw it. Ballooning the pressure right. And his throw here is incomplete.
I'm sure it was a tough halftime trying to figure out some strategy to get things going, trailing by a lot when they went into the locker room. He's just trying every avenue to spark his team here to begin the third quarter. Not a lot going on that play, though.
Here's Hurts to throw. He finds his man complete. That's Young. And he'll be brought down at the 28, and that is well short of the first. They're going to try and throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. Boy, a curious decision to go for it. Doesn't pan out. And the Bears are going to get the football back, and they're going to get it in great field position. On first down, it's Fields. That's to Moore, he's got it. Touchdown, Bears. A great effort there. His 17th touchdown now on the season. And the Bears just continue to roll. So that pretty conclusively, I might add, shows you the perils of going for it and not making it on fourth down. One play, touchdown.
Yeah, and I've got to put this on the man in charge, the head coach. He made the decision to go for it. To me, when punting was the only decision to make, and it backfired on him in a big way.
And his kick is good, and flags fly as well. Some frustration showing through right now. This is going to be a roughing call.
And they'll accept that penalty.
After the roughing penalty on the PAT, they'll kick off from 15 yards further upfield. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29.
Their own 29-yard line.
Hurts and the Eagles come up here first and 10, just shy of the 30. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
And there's another stop.
So she leave her best friends. Bust out my dad face. Your chain is a necklace. On the stallion and Doja, her top half, huh? 2300 on the horse and I'm Mike. Switching out the character, the strippers like tigers. Legends on 3, 2, 1.
Oh, you tried it. You say you love me like you love him. You lying. You know your worth for what it's worth. I could buy it. We'll say it's only at the top, but I'm biased. Because I'm only at the
Right, Tom.